Hey guys, this is Zach with 8020 Media, here today with a video on the BMW N54 versus B58 engines. The BMW N54 was initially released back in 2007 and was predominantly used from 2007 until 2010. And then BMW moved on to the next generation, which was the BMW N55 engine. And then finally the current version of the engine, which is the BMW B58. And that has been used since 2016 up through the present day. Jumping right into a couple basic specs for these engines, both the N54 and B58 are 3-liter. Turbocharged inline six engines. One notable difference right off the bat is that the N54 does use a twin turbo setup, whereas the BMW B58 engine uses a single twin scroll turbocharger. The N54, the older engine produced from 2007 to 2010, primarily BMW did use the engine a little bit after that, but mostly in those 2007 to 2010 models, and notably the 135, 335, and 535i models. So the B58 does use a closed deck block, which is a big upgrade for people looking to make a lot of power. The open deck block on the N54 hasn't really been a major issue, but when you do start pushing above 700, 750 wheel horsepower, that open deck block can become a concern. Great upgrade for the B58 to have the closed deck block straight from the factory. Both the N54 and B58 have forged rods and a forged crankshaft, but just standard cast pistons. Despite the cast design of those pistons, they remain fairly strong on both engines. The B58, the standard engine, does use an 11.0:1 compression ratio, and the BMW N54 always had a 10.2:1 compression ratio, so a little bump up for the B58 there. The B58 actually is ever so slightly larger, so it comes in at 2,998 cc's, whereas the older N54 is 2,979 cc's, so about 20 extra cc's for the newer B58 engine. Nothing major, but again, a little bit larger of an engine. The B58 also switched to a longer stroke and a thinner bore, and includes BMW's valvetronic technology, or variable valve lift, which the N54 did not receive back in the day. Another major update looking at the newest B58 is that the B58 does use air to water intercooler instead of the typical air to air intercooler like on the N54. So a little bit of an advantage for the B58 there, since the air-to-water intercooler typically holds up a little bit better to heat soak and isn't as important of an upgrade like a larger FMIC is on the 335 or on those older N54s. One consideration if you're in the market for a B58, there are two major variants of the B58, and that's the original B58, which was predominantly from 2016 to 2019. And then BMW made some updates to the B58, which is now known as the B58 TU. Couple changes that occurred with that TU update, and this happened on the G chassis, so the newer like G20 and G22 3 and 4 series. One notable update is on the upper output variant, the one that does make 382 horsepower. BMW did actually drop the compression from 11:1 down to 10.2:1 for the upper tier output variant of the B58. And the cylinder head is now integrated into the exhaust manifold. The fuel system was upgraded to a 350 bar fuel system, so about 5,000 PSI, whereas the older direct injection system on the B58 was capable of 200 bar or about 2,900 PSI. So a couple good updates for the B58 moving on to that newer B58 TU. So the N54 produces 300 horsepower and 300 pound-feet of torque, whereas on the other hand, the newer B58 engine, despite only using a single turbocharger instead of twin turbos, actually produces a decent bit more power than the N54. So stock power figures come in at 322 to 382 horsepower and 332 to 369 pound-feet of torque. So decent advantage to the B58 straight out of the factory. Moving on to mods and tuning for the B58 versus N54 engines. They'll both have similar mods in terms of reaching full bolt-on, both similar mods in the sense that you'll be looking at tuning. intake upgrades, downpipes, and then some fueling upgrades. And again, on the N54, you'll want to look at a larger front mount intercooler. Whereas the intercooler is pretty efficient and effective on the B58, as long as you're sticking with the stock turbo. After that, you might consider upgrading the B58 intercooler. Both the N54 and B58 can make about 450 to 500 wheel horsepower with those basic bolt-on mods. That'll be about the limit for each engine respectively on their stock turbo setup, so the stock single turbo on the B58 or the stock twin turbos on the N54. Some have pushed a little beyond 500 wheel horsepower, but not everyone should expect to see those kind of results without upgrading the turbochargers. But again, with basic bolt-ons, both of these engines will end up in a very similar ballpark for power and performance. And they can both also easily achieve 700 plus wheel horsepower with upgraded turbos, or an upgraded turbo in the case of the B58. So both very tuner and mod friendly and very capable engines. I'd say one notable difference, and I expect the B58 will hold up just as well in the long run, but maybe one advantage to the N54 is it's been around a lot longer. It's already proven itself. Its limits are pretty well known and understood. And the N54 has proven time and time again that it can keep moving without skipping a beat. Whether or not the B58 holds up like that, especially when the B58 hits ages of 10 to 15 years old, only time will tell if it truly holds up as well as the N54 has. But all things on paper look good for the B58, and everything that we've seen so far makes it suggest that the B58 should be just as capable, if not more capable, than the N54 in the long term. But again, still have a waiting game to see if it really does hold up that well over the course of 10, 12, 15 years. Moving on to reliability, this is where the B58 gets a huge win. The N54 is not very well known for reliability, runs into a ton of issues, especially in the early days. It had a lot of high pressure fuel pump problems, fuel injector issues, turbocharger failures, and wastegate rattle, along with all of the cooling system leaks, oil leaks, boost leaks. Basically, the N54 is very strong internally, but anything outside of the engine is known to be problematic. Some things are more problematic than others, but ultimately, if it's something that isn't inside of the N54 itself, basically can and probably will go wrong at some point on the N54. The B58, on the other hand, obviously has an advantage. It's about 7 to 10 years newer than N54s, and so being the younger engine naturally gives it a slight edge in reliability, lower mileage, less age for things like gaskets, hoses to crack and develop leaks. That age is already a benefit to the B58, and on top of that, it's just a much more reliable engine and design in general. So a couple things to look out for on the B58 are valve cover gasket leaks. That's an issue on the N54 too, but we'll see if those become more common on the B58. So far, it seems to be a less common issue. Same thing with vano solenoids and PCV valve problems. Both issues on the N54 too seem a little less common on the B58 so far. And other than that, there aren't really any major reliability concerns or complaints about the B58. But there still are a couple things to consider. Again, it's a little bit of a newer engine, so we'll see when these things start hitting 10 or 12 years old if they run into a lot of oil leaks and coolant leaks like the N54 has, or if the B58 holds up to be much more reliable in the longer term than the N54. Certainly at this point in time, huge advantage to the B58 when it comes to reliability. Another final comparison for the N54 and B58 is price. If you're considering these two cars, I'm sure you've realized that there's a pretty big difference in price between the two. Of course, the N54, predominantly being 2007 to 2010, you can pick up most of these N54 models for somewhere in like the $7,000 to $12,000 ballpark, maybe a little bit less if it's a poor, crappy example, or a little bit more if you're finding a super clean example that's been well maintained and has a lot of big maintenance items already knocked out in the last couple of years. Right around that $10,000 ballpark, give or take a few thousand, is roughly what you'll pay for most N54s. The B58, on the other hand, looking at something like a 340i, a 440i, you'll probably be shelling out $22,000 on the lower end of that spectrum, and then anywhere up to $30,000 or $35,000. And then, of course, if you're looking at a newer B58, since they are still in production, you could still go buy a car with a brand new B58 in it. You could be looking at $60,000 plus. So obviously a big difference in price there, and the one big advantage for the N54 is that even though it's less reliable, you could go pick up an N54, knock out all of the preventative maintenance items and even have some money left over in the budget to start modifying it, refreshing the suspension, all that stuff, and you could still walk away with a car that was cheaper than a B58 in the long run. So that about wraps it up for this N54 versus B58 video. Quick summary here, the B58 is simply the newer, more advanced engine out of the two. However, despite its newer design and being a little more advanced than the older N54, they're actually pretty similarly capable when it comes to mods and tuning, and will both end up at roughly the same power and torque with the same mods on them. The B58 is the much more reliable engine out of the two, but the N54 has that price advantage. So that sums it up for this N54 versus B58 video. If you guys appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and check out the description below for more awesome content on the N54 and B58. Thanks, guys.